I never dreamed I'd see you again, standing here at my door. Well, I'm not sure I wanna let you in. You know what happened before.
Get your clothes on, quick.
What's going on?
I'll tell you later. Hurry up. I don't want to lose the weasel.
Mom! What if someone was staying with me? You can't just barge into my apartment at 6 o'clock in
Seven.
The morning.
You have the same tendency to exaggeration I have, which is not good.
Well, can I at least know what this is about?
Your father's cheating on me.
Dad. Straight arrow Clay Chadway is having an affair. Mom, I don't think so.
Well, that's one response. Should be on his way down with the slut. Bribed a bellboy. At least we'll know who it is.
Would you repeat that, Mom?
I bribed a bellboy. You need to spend money to get things done in life. Ask your father.
Are you feeling okay? Do you think that maybe
there.
We should...
There! There he is! Oh, I swear it hurts, honey. I hope you never have to find out how much. Wait. Wait. Someone's coming.
He's having an affair with another man. Just say you're wrong, Mom.
I'm not wrong. I know.
Just say it.
I'm wrong. This time.
Let's go.
I'm at him all the time. It's like a bad itch, you know? Maybe it's just that I'm just getting old.
Dad loves you.
Sometimes I think it's guilt. Guilt that... We made all this money, and that I know how we made it. We built our lives on deception.
Not the Alabama story again.
When we first got here, we were two hicks from Nowheresville, Alabama. Now we're two old hicks, pretending to be the pillars of the community. Oh, it's terrible to feel yourself getting old.
Oh, you are a beautiful woman, Mom. Dad hasn't forgotten that. He loves you.
You think so?
I see it in his eyes every time he looks at you. Come on, take me home, okay? I gotta rest. I gotta sing tonight.
I'm so excited. You're finally gonna go short. It's gonna be so cute on you. So cute.
Lisa.
Can you excuse me just for a second, okay? Just for a second.
Is there something wrong with Mom?
Where should I start?
No, I mean something new. She's been following Dad around. She thinks he's having an affair.
Maybe he is.
Never. He just wouldn't.
I don't think you see Daddy very clearly. As far as you're concerned, he can do no wrong.
You're making me sorry I talked to you.
So stop. I have to go back to work anyway. Look. I am not an expert on Dad's sex life, but if you really want to know, ask him.
Sorry.
They always see problems. Where other folks see problems, they see opportunity. Where other men just see obstacles. Rules, regulations, government agencies, they can't stop you if you've got the willpower and the brains to get the job done. And that's what this company is built on, gentlemen. Vision, excuse me.
Mr. Chadwell, your daughter's here.
That's going to be right out. And now Charlie will show you the drawings.
Thank you, Clay.
Excuse me, John.
Now.
Thanks.
Thank you, Cheryl. Well, what's on your mind?
Dad. I need to ask you a personal question.
Go ahead, shoot.
Are you having an affair?
No. Next question.
Well, Mom thinks you are.
Well, your mother's always thought the best of me.
She's pretty wigged out about it.
Mean it?
She's convinced that she's right.
Well, you know how your mother is when she gets something stuck in her head. Men have affairs. I'm a man, therefore I'm having an affair, which I'm not. Joanne, you know what I think's happening is that, I think your mother's just feeling old. Mm-hmm. That's got to be hard for a beautiful woman. We just have to be patient with her.
Okay.
Well, is today the day you're going to let me move you out of that slum you call home?
No, Dad, I didn't come here for that. I don't want your money.
Oh, yeah. Bobby does. He can't get enough. And your sister. One lives at home and does nothing. The other one lives at home and thinks she has to spend her whole salary on clothes and nightclubs.
Well, if I'm going to make it, it's going to be on my own.
Thank God one of my children's like me.
Charlotte, who left that open?
Listen to me, damn it! Do you know what I was doing down there?
I do know, that's the trouble. Bobby! Bobby!
I was planning a surprise party.
Oh.
A party for our 34th wedding anniversary.
Like hell you were.
You were?
That's why I got up so early. I figured I could sneak out without waking you up, go down there and meet the party man, plan the party with him, and still have my whole work day.
Mercury's in retrograde.
Something sure as hell is.
The electric gate was open when I came home, and the back doors to the house were open.
No, where's Bobby?
He never goes out. You've seen to that.
Me?
You've always treated him like outcast.
Careful now, Renee. Careful. A long time ago, we set some boundaries. Don't cross them.
You're gonna be back
late. Don't wait up, okay?
You need to go hear Joanne?
What for? I want to have fun.
That's our fault. You don't like each other more.
I'd say it's her fault myself.
Good night, Mom. Sleep tight, okay?
Where's Daddy?
On the way to Barstow, I guess. Wait. Turn around. You look beautiful.
applause to Mr. Jim and Kim Bohager. Yeah. Great work, fellas.
All right. Real good.
Yeah. Good to have a family here in cahoots and don't belong to the mafia. We're all having a good time here tonight. All right, hey, listen up now. We have a real live A&R guy from Steel String Records. That's right. So some of the folks you witnessed tonight in cahoots just might get famous.
He didn't tell us that.
All right, now, here we go, folks. Our next act coming on stage is already famous around here for purity of voice and, well, sheer beauty. It'd be hard to top our very own Joanne Chadway and Sam Rance. Come on now, guys. Give it up. Come on now. Come on now. Come on.
Hi, we're real happy to be here at In Cahoots, and we'd like to start off with an old Joan Baez song, one of my faves. Just wish I could do it like she did.
Yeah, so do we.
Well, I'll be damned, here comes your ghost again. But that's not unusual, it's just that the moon is full and you happen to call. And here I sit, hand on the telephone, hearing a voice I'd known a couple of light years ago, heading straight for a fall.
Where you been playing? Mostly,
you know, small clubs around here. We did a couple of gigs in L.A., though.
Got a demo?
Yes.
No, wait. I can't do anything without a demo. The executive's got to hear you.
Well, we'll get you one.
As soon as I have it, I'll get them to listen and we'll see what happens, huh? Here's my card. My secretary will take any messages when I'm on the road and I'll get back to you. Nice to meet you both.
Nice to meet you.
Wish I could stay longer so I could take you to dinner.
Wait. You don't have a demo.
We'll get one. We'll make one. I'll borrow the money from Daddy.
Joanne,
yeah?
Phone call.
Tell him I'll call him back.
It's your brother. It's about your mom.
Any sight of her, Bobby?
They're not talking yet. Hey, Sam. They called me out to identify the car. I couldn't make him talk.
Did you call Dad yet?
Yeah, I left him a message at Barstow.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm nervous, I guess.
Who's in charge here?
I am. Detective Winters. And this is Detective Herndon.
Hi.
And you are?
Joanne Chadway.
And you?
A friend.
Why is my mother's car here?
Well, that's what we're trying to find out, ma'am. Can you help us?
Well, who found it?
An officer, about an hour and a half ago. 12:24 a.m., to be exact.
Do you know anything else?
Nothing conclusive yet, ma'am. We're just...
You don't call people out in the middle of the night just because you find a car by the side of the road. You don't call out lab trucks, either.
You're Clay Chadway's daughter, aren't you?
Yes.
How'd I know? We found some blood in the car, on the steering wheel and the driver's seat. Now, just not much. Just a bit. But we're trying to track down everything now. We're not pressing the panic button yet. We're just checking things out.
Oh, Mom. Oh, Mom. No.
Thanks for coming back at such short notice, Mr. Chadway.
Yeah, well, I wasn't about to stay away doing business when someone might have kidnapped my wife.
We don't know she was kidnapped.
Well, I'd like to hear your theories.
Thanks very much.
We wanted to get back home here just as quick as possible.
Do you have any reason to believe someone might have kidnapped her?
No. But it appears you folks do.
What was her emotional state like recently? Was she in a good mood?
Mood? Well, Renee's moods are kind of like the English weather. One minute she's smooth as glass, and the next minute you can't see the prow from the stern.
No recent marital discord.
What's that got to do with anything? Renee and I always had marital discord. Hell, our marriage was practically built on marital discord. But I love her. I love her. That's why we've been married for 34 years.
Either you or Mrs. Chadway had any extramarital affairs lately?
Why are we sitting here talking like this? Huh? Why aren't you out there doing something? Or if you're not going to, why aren't I out there doing something? What the hell's the difference if I slept with the whole damn Dallas cheerleader corps? Which I didn't. I missed a few. Oh, hell. Renee? It's your mother. It's your mother.
Renee's back.
Renee, where the hell have you been?
Look at this, Clay. Look at this photograph of us when we got married. Mm. Now I ask you, did we look like Republicans then?
Renee, you're really gone too far this time.
Look, Alabama.
Yes, it's Alabama.
Mom, did you know the police were looking for you? That's them over there.
Of course, it would be.
Come on.
I decided to commit suicide. Well, I decided to try, that is. See the cut? There's another one.
Take her into the house. I'll get yours.
And then I said, yeah, I might as well leave myself the option of just disappearing, but I walked instead to the nearest bar.
I was going to get
No. I took a photograph of him. Now that's a living history, or dead history. Oh, look at us, Clay. So much in love. So young and in love. Look.
Pastimes of the rich and famous.
I'm saving up.
Me too.
Oh.
Look how pretty she is there. Huh?
Oh.
Look at that. You were and you are a very beautiful woman.
I can't believe you two. I can't believe it.
Joanne?
Look. This one.
Joel. Come on, Joanne.
Oh, I remember that.
Joanne. What do you want me to do? You want me to yell at her? You want me to hate her? Because if I did that every time your mother did something irrational, we wouldn't have stayed married for 2 years. And I wouldn't have my favorite daughter. Now, come on.
Okay, Daddy. You were all 5 here. Do you remember our house in LA?
Are you okay, Mom?
Evidence. That's what these are. Evidence.
Evidence of what, Mom?
A life. 2 lives. Many lives. But they're not what you think. And just when you think they're safely buried, they roar up and bite you on the heart.
Come on, Amanda.
From the chorus. 2, 3, 4.
How can I forget?
Oh, now I'm doing it.
What?
I'm being crazy. My fault. Let's go again.
No. Let's go to bed.
Later. Let's get it right first and work on our so-called careers.
We're not going to have careers if we stay here, Joanne. We got to grab this chance.
I think this is the right key. Joanne? Mom? What now?
He's with someone.
I don't care, Mom. You can't keep barging into my apartment at all hours of the night.
I'm sorry. Hi, Sam. Mm-hmm. Come with me, Joanne. This is the last time I swear on a stack of Bibles.
No, Mom, I won't do it.
Joanne. Please. Oh, honey, thank you.
Damn you, Mom. If you're wrong, you have to promise me you're gonna see a shrink.
I promise. Let's get going. Come on.
Joanne, you're as nuts as they are. You're codependent, enabling. I forget what else.
Told you I'd be right back. Where are they now?
They went in the restaurant over there.
Thank you, young.
Good evening. Hello. Table for two?
No.
Are you looking for someone?
I found him. Well, oh my, Ellen. Well, this is a bit low rent even for us, isn't it, Clay? Finding you with my sister?
What are you doing here, Aunt Ellen?
You're gonna hate yourself for this, Renee.
I certainly hope so. It'll feel a lot better than it does now.
Dad.
Ask your aunt.
I came to get a loan from Clay, honey.
In exchange for what? How many times
did
you...
Stop it, Renee. Stop it.
Here. This one's on me.
Dad, if you're sleeping with Aunt Ellen, it's cruel.
We're not.
Well, there are phones and wire transfers. Why did you have to come all the way here to get a loan?
Because I felt I had to explain the situation to your father in person.
Really?
Yes, Jan, really.
Well, why didn't you ask Mom?
She wouldn't help me.
Charlie, go.
I send her home. Here, help me with this.
Mom, you can't get off the grounds. The front gate is down because of the storm. You know, Dad's telling the truth, too.
You don't know everything.
Neither do you, Mom. Aunt Ellen's here because she's in trouble and she says she needs help.
Yeah, when you're hiding something, you'll say anything.
Well, at least wait until I can check out the story. It's easy enough to check.
You're all wet. Get out of those clothes.
I'm not staying. There's a cab waiting for me.
Of course,
Mom!
Stay.
Mom, please, stop this.
Okay. What?
Promise me you won't do anything until tomorrow, when I get a chance to check out their stories. You owe me this, Mom.
I promise.
No. I don't want some idle, easy promise. I want a real promise, like crossing your heart or swearing on your mother's grave or something.
Cross my heart.
Okay.
Take my raincoat, sugar. I know you're trying to help me, but don't worry, I'm not going to do anything foolish. I'll be fine. I'll be fine.
Last night, why? When did you get home?
6:30. I was at a bar when the storm hit, so a bunch of us stayed.
And she was gone.
Well, her car's still here.
Are her clothes there?
There's a suitcase on the bed, but she didn't take it.
She promised me, damn it.
What?
I'll call you later, okay?
Okay, bye.
Cheryl, is my dad in his office?
He was here when I got in. I think he slept here. Some storm, huh?
Yeah.
Well, hi, sweetheart. Did you see that storm last night?
Mom's gone again.
Gone where?
Well, she couldn't get her car out of the front gate, so I'm thinking she took a cab.
Well, who told you she was gone?
Lisa.
Oh, since when? Talked to her just last night.
Well, Lisa got home early this morning, and she wasn't there.
Renee, this is Clay. Where are you? Hey, give me a call at the office when you get back, will you? Want some breakfast?
I'm not hungry. I'm afraid she's going to hurt herself.
Oh, she's not going to hurt herself. Women like Renee Mae Broderick don't hurt themselves. They're made out of steel.
Nobody's that strong. She's been acting crazy because she's afraid.
Afraid of what?
Afraid of losing you, Dad. Damn. Why do these things always have to happen at the exact wrong time?
Nothing's happened yet. What do you mean?
Nothing.
Now, Joanne.
It's just that this guy came to the club the other day and he liked us. He wanted a demo.
Well, so? Let's make one.
Well, I don't have enough money.
Yeah, well, I have. How much will it take?
Stop it, Dad. I just... This is the wrong time to talk about it.
Joanne, there is no wrong time. The whole world is not going to come to a stop just because Renee is having another one of her fits. Now, how much will it take? Huh? Joanne, tell me. All right, I'll make a deal with you, all right? We'll treat it as a loan. Fair enough?
Fair enough.
Good. Oh, I'm so happy for you. Oh, that's just great.
Hey, Bobby.
Yeah. Hey. How's it going, sis?
Have you heard from Mom?
Mom? You know she avoids me. And I avoid her because, I don't know, she's completely hysterical over Dad.
Well, I think she's left home again.
I'm not surprised.
Have you seen Dad?
Now you must have the wrong Bobby. Last time I saw Dad, he told me to get Rolfed or something. Stop slouching. I never see you either.
Well, that's because you're always holed up in here. I'd see you, Bobby, if I thought you wanted me to. Why don't you come see us tonight? We're playing at the club. Maybe we could go out afterwards.
Yeah. Maybe. You're playing, huh? You're worried about Mom, huh?
Yeah. I'm worried about you, too.
She's out there these days, you know. She's on Dad like a bird dog. It's just, I don't know. I wonder if it's better not to have so much money. I mean, not that I have it.
No. It's deeper than that. I don't know, it's something different. Yeah. Does she ever talk to you about Alabama?
Alabama? Where's that?
Hi.
Hey! Does my hair look okay like this?
Oh yeah, it's fine. Why? Where are you going?
Date. You know, someone to watch over me.
Did Mom call?
Uh-uh, not yet. Maybe she left him for real this time. That's one way to stop being paranoid.
Mr. Chadway! There's a fax about your wife.
Trying to call you.
We have to talk.
Now? I've got a gig.
Well, that's going to have to wait. Joanne, your mother's been kidnapped.
What?
She's been kidnapped. Deliver the ransom.
Is this real?
Afraid so.
Do the police know about this?
No, not yet. No, I've been agonizing over this. And you and I have to decide whether or not to tell them. And we don't have much time.
Mm-hmm.
Daddy's right here. Your daddy's right here. It's okay.
We'll have more questions for you later. It's okay, Miss Chadway. It's been dusted.
Like on TV?
Yeah, that's where we get our best ideas.
Miss Chadway around? The other one?
Oh, yeah, she's coming. This is my whole family, except for her. You know my attorney, Terry Lennox?
Mm-hmm. Detective.
Here she is.
Now, I take it that you and you didn't know about the ransom note. Is that right?
We don't know about anything. No one bothers to tell us.
So it was just you and Joanne who,
I took her into my confidence.
Let's see the card.
Stated over 24 hours ago.
You paid the ransom at midnight? And Mrs. Chadway was to be released this morning, and you called us at 3 p.m.
We made a mistake.
Yes, you did. And because you did, we've lost a lot of valuable time.
Well, we thought we had to take the chance.
Well, why is that, Miss Chadway? I wouldn't have taken the chance of singing at the Grand Old Opry if I'd never sung before.
You've made your point, Detective.
Okay. Just a few more questions.
Didn't you ask those all last time?
Humor me.
Last time?
Well, why don't you go and find the people that took her instead of interrogating us? She might be hurt or dead or something.
He's got to ask these questions now. Just calm down. Calm down.
Mr. Chadway, did you and your wife have any fights prior to her disappearance?
Yes.
What about?
Nothing.
What about, Mr. Chadway?
Clay, you don't have
it's
to...
Right.
You're making right. Something out of nothing.
She accused me of sleeping with her sister, Ellen.
I see. Were you sleeping with her?
No!
Joanne. No, I wasn't.
What put that idea into her head?
She found us together at a hotel, in a restaurant.
Ha! I knew it!
Mrs. Chadway's sister was having serious financial problems. Mr. Chadway arranged to get some funds to her quickly. His wife misinterpreted it.
You can document this?
Yes, we can.
Hey, Jack. Gotta see this.
Can I wait?
Don't think so. Watch this. We covered the room with luminol.
Luminol glows in the presence of blood.
Plus a lot of other things. A turpentine. High gloss paint.
Yeah, right.
It's quite a show in this room.
What are you talking about?
Real fine pattern like this? Might have been a small caliber bullet.
You're jumping ahead of yourself, Detective.
So what you're saying is that my mother was killed in her own bed?
Somebody was.
$500 fine if they trace that back to us.
Clay can afford it.
Here,
help me with this.
Here, hold that down.
Here, got it.
Get that corner. Here, I'll help you.
Okay. You got it?
Yeah.
Ah! Whoa! You have another one?
There's another one.
Okay.
Yeah.
The Blood Brothers.
The Blood Siblings. What if it was Mom's blood on the bed? It wasn't. It wasn't even blood. Then why did the police demand to take our blood test? I don't know.
Give me that stapler. I'm gonna go do that poll.
You guys just go ahead, okay?
get the results of your blood test back. The blood on the bed isn't any of yours.
Well, we knew that. You're not even sure if it's blood yet.
Oh, it's blood, all right. Mind if I ask you a question, Miss Chadway?
Well, that depends.
Are your siblings adopted?
What are you talking about? Of course not. Why are you asking me this?
Well, their blood types aren't compatible with your father's.
You lost me there.
He's not their biological father.
Well, what are you telling me? Of course he is.
Mm-mm. Blood doesn't lie, Miss Chadway.
You kids managed to put up flyers on a day like this. Yeah, by the way, I hired a detective agency to look for Renee. They're going to drop by later and take their own fingerprints off the bedroom. Yeah. What's the matter, sweetheart? Oh, come on now. What's wrong with my little girl?
I'm just scared, I guess.
Yeah. Scared.
Boys, come on now, take it outside. Folks, come on, let's give a nice hand to Joanne Chadway. Come on now, nice hand.
Hi, y'all. It's nice to be back here at In Cahoots. Feels just like home. Before I start, though, I'd like to dedicate this song to my mother. She's been missing for a few days, and I'm really worried about her. This is my mother. So if any of you think you've seen her, would you please let me know after the show? Thanks.
Excuse me. Hi, excuse me. Look, you guys don't know me. I'm Jed Harker. I think I saw your mother.
Where?
I was in Indian country about 3 days ago, and I saw this car at this tourist stop. Two guys and a woman in the back. And I thought it was kind of funny because this lady was kind of on edge and looked like she didn't belong with them. I think it was that woman in the photo.
Well, can you remember the name of the place?
No.
Please try. It's very important.
Blue something. Blue skies. Something. Sorry.
Thank you very much. Much further?
About 30 miles.
Do you think Mom could have gone back to Alabama?
Alabama? Why? Why would she want to go there?
A woman came by here with a couple of men.
When?
I'm not really sure. But I heard them say something about staying up at the dam. Might have been her.
What dam is this?
There's one right up the road.
Yeah, Will. Thank you, Jim. Thanks for your time.
Someone who looks like it came through maybe 15 minutes ago, heading for the dam.
Thank you.
You want something?
We're never gonna find her.
Oh, no. People do remember. We're gonna find her.
That must be how you made all your money, by being positive.
Well, that was part of it.
I must have some of Mom's skepticism.
Well, that's not a bad thing to have. Sure helped us a time or two. I remember once, I was fixing to invest in some offshore soybean farms. And your mother looked at me and she said, Clay, are you sure that soybeans really do grow in salt water? I want to tell you, that saved us a bunch.
She used to do all the books, didn't she?
Yeah. She was the best damn bookkeeper in the world. She's really the best at anything she really set her mind to.
Do you think that Mom's still alive?
I'm sure she is.
How can you be so sure?
Because I think your mother engineered all this.
How?
Has all the earmarks of a Rene job. The blood on the headboard, the disappearance without the car, the ransom notes. I think she's trying to punish me.
Because you're having an affair with Aunt Ellen.
No, I said.
Dad, don't lie to me. I know it's true.
It is not true, Joanne. Even though the sex part of your mother's and my marriage ended a long time ago. Your mother's the one who ended it. Look, Joanne, I'm not saying I'm a saint. I'm human, just like everybody else. But I will tell you one thing. You're wrong about your Aunt Ellen.
And she was here just because she needed money, and that's it.
That's it. Joanne, you've got to believe me. You do. Because I need you in my corner right now.
Why, Dad?
My lawyer says that the police are going to arrest me.
Arrest you for what?
For killing your mother.
Hadley Brood.
Oh, yeah, okay, but I...
You're the one that does those concerts for your mother?
Yeah, that's right.
I think that is so moving. Now, listen, I'm with this show, National Focus. We can get you some major publicity.
No, I'm just doing this so I can find her. Thanks anyway.
Yeah, but honey, she could be anywhere. Our show goes into millions of homes every week. Now, that's a lot more people than you're going to reach, you know, singing at that little club of yours. Now, here, let me give you my business card. There you go. So... Where are you going now?
To the airport, to Alabama.
Uh-huh.
Let's go, okay?
Okay. Call me! I can help you find your mother!
See you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow. Take care.
Yeah. Well, I thought you'd come here sooner or later.
That can't be good for you.
Well, what is? What can I do for you, Jane?
You can tell me the truth.
Well, what about? And would you believe me if I told you?
Yes, I would. Who is Lisa and Bobby's real father? We took blood tests.
Clay can't be their father, so who is?
Ask Clay.
I don't want to upset him with this right now.
So forget it. What difference does it make?
It might help me find my mom.
Yeah, well, what about Lisa and Bobby? Do they know about this yet?
I don't know. I don't think so.
Just where the hell are you going?
Hey, Dad. Thought I might go down to Mexico for the weekend.
Well, you planning on taking a vacation? With your mother still missing? You out of your damn mind. Where's Joanne? Got something I want to talk over with her. You know where she is?
Don't know.
Don't know. You don't know. Well, just what is it you do know? Just what is it you do in this room all by yourself, all day long, every day? There's just so much belly button scratching a man can do, isn't there? Or maybe you're planning on writing a thesis on four walls. Because you sure as hell know him well enough. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Sorry about me. It's just, I don't know, I just want you to, I want you to do well. Look, son, I know I'm part of the problem.
Joanne went to Beauville. She went to see Aunt Helen. Remember?
This was our house. All three of us were born here.
Not Bobby.
No? I thought that Mom said
that... Well, if she did, she was wrong. Your father bought this house after Bobby arrived. One thing your mother always had is guts. Nerve.
She may have done some damn foolish things, but she never lost her nerve. Some of us are content to sit in the back row and wait and see what life's got to show us. But not your mama. She's always up there putting on the show. I don't feel like the ghost of Christmas past.
You want to see more, don't you?
I want to see everything.
Well, you hold on tight.
Whose house is this?
Lisa's father lives here. You can go see if he's home if you want to.
What's his name?
Joe Fielding.
Mr. Fielding?
Hello.
are you?
My name's Joanne Chadway. I'm Renee Chadway's daughter.
Who?
Renee Broderick. No, I have a sister.
So, how's all Clay doing?
You knew my mother was carrying your child?
She lived with me for 4 months. You'd have to be blind not to. Come on, sit down.
When did you meet my mother?
When you were in high school. Well, put it this way, quite a few of us knew your mother.
What do you mean by that? What do you mean by that, Mr. Fielding?
Oh, nothing. Nothing. So how is old Clay? I still remember his face when he came to get her, to take her back to that fine house. He had bought her a fine house, but he couldn't keep her in it. He stood right there, terrified I was gonna punch him or something. Or she was gonna punch him. I almost busted a gut laughing.
He owns a development company. He builds malls. He's got a 15-room house and 4 cars.
That's so.
Yes, that's so. You know, I used to think that my sister was missing something by not knowing who her father was. But now I realize why my parents never told her about you. Hi, can I see Ellen Broderick, please? I'm her niece.
Ellen didn't come in to work today. May I help you?
No, thanks.
Talk some more.
Just take your hand away. I promise I won't scream.
Well, I'll just keep it here for a bit if you don't mind. So, Clay's a big man now. He's got a lot of money.
Yeah. Where's my mama?
How much does he have?
I don't know.
How much would he pay to keep a secret? Take a guess.
If you ever touch a child of mine again, I will kill you, so help me.
told you about Lisa?
The police told me that you couldn't be Lisa or Bobby's father. And I got the truth out of Aunt Ellen. But if she hadn't have told me, I would have gotten the truth someplace else.
Well, Joanne, you're mature enough to handle it. I'm not sure Lisa and Bobby are. Now, you shouldn't be so hard on your mother. I forgave her. I think you ought to try to forgive her, too.
Well, why'd she do it?
She couldn't help it. None of us can, to tell you the truth. Now, another man might have kicked her butt out of the house, never looked back. But I loved her, and that was that.
Well, that wouldn't be that for me. If my husband had a child with another woman, I'd leave him if I hadn't killed...
Hush, hush! Hush, don't you say that.
Where are we?
Where it all began for Renee. It's where she was born. It's where she lived when I met her. This is the Broderick family mansion in all its glory.
What are we doing here?
There's another question you have for me, isn't there, sweetheart? I'll answer it. You'll have to keep it a secret, but I'll answer it.
Who's Bobby's father, Dad?
Harvey W. Broderick.
What?
He was Renee's father.
I don't know what to ask, Dad.
Well, there's still plenty of time.
Well, when did you find out?
When she got pregnant. She just turned 16. I was 25. I didn't find out until it was too late what a vicious bastard her father was. I wanted to shoot him. But Renee, she didn't want me to. Then I wanted to tell someone. But she said the shame would kill her.
So what did you do, Dad?
I married her. To this day, I still think that she believes the only reason I married her was because I wanted to save her from the shame. But that's not true. No, I married her because I loved her. I adored her. I still do. Well, we had Bobby. And soon after that, we had you.
What happened to him?
Broderick? Pretended he was a grandfather.
And Lisa?
After you were born, your mother had what the doctors called a nervous breakdown. She'd go out of the house at dusk and she'd just stay out all night. Let's get out of here.
Wait a minute, Dad. Are there any more secrets? Anything else I should know about?
No. Except that Bobby and Lisa don't know. I don't want you to tell them. There's nothing to gain from it.
Joanne, Hadley Brood. Call me at 505-555-0199 as soon as you get in. I have good news. Joanne, where are you? Call me. We have a lot to do. Joanne, Hadley, we've arranged to have our cameras at In Cahoots tonight.
You really want to do this? You really want us to sing on National Focus?
Why not? It might help me find my mom.
I hope so. But what about us, Joanne? We're going to be a sideshow.
What do you mean? mean?
We're gonna look like a singing milk carton, and for what? For phony leads from a few thousand nuts who want to be on TV.
Well, if one of them knows where my mom is, it'll be worth it, won't it?
Jill Beasley offered me a job doing backup.
Great! Great gig!
At least it's real. At least it's going someplace and not part of some dysfunctional family fantasy.
You take it then! Go be functional! But in the meantime, get out of here!
Hi, where do you want me?
Oh, right there is fine.
Hey, folks, we have with us a very special guest with us this evening. She's got a beautiful voice and, well, we're rooting for her. All right, let's give a nice, warm round of applause for one of our very own Miss Joanne Chadway. Yeah.
Thank you. It's great to be back here at In Cahoots, but before I begin, I guess you all know by now that my mom's missing, and I'm asking any one of you that might have seen her to please come forward. This is her photograph. So, if any of you think you might have seen her in the past 4 weeks, please, please see me after the show. Thank you.
Mr. Chadway. You're under arrest for the murder of Renee Chadway. You have the right to remain silent. If you give up the right to remain silent, anything you say can and will be used against you in a court of law. You have the right to speak with an attorney and to have the attorney present during questioning. If you so desire and cannot afford one, an attorney will be appointed for you without charge before questioning.
Chadway,
are you going to make bail?
Do you think your father did it?
Are you going to ask your father to confess?
Joanne, just a few questions.
Over here, darling. Is there money involved?
There's a hitch on posting the bond. Nothing serious. He'll be out in a couple of hours. But there's no reason for you to wait around here.
But I want to, Terry.
It could take longer. It could take all night. Plus the circus when we finally get out of here. I say go home. Wait for Clay there, okay?
Am I interrupting anything?
No, nothing that can't wait. Did you see yourself on TV?
That was a mistake.
You think so? Well, somebody might have seen her.
What are you doing?
Nothing, just looking at some old pictures.
You miss her, don't you?
Yeah. Dad home yet? There he is.
Hmm?
Dad's back.
Daddy!
How's my girl?
Oh. So what did they say? Are they going to let you stay here?
Yeah, as long as the bail holds. They said they got enough circumstantial evidence to charge me, though.
We've hired the best criminal lawyer in the state, and we're going to do everything we can to make certain your father walks away from this.
In a way, it's kind of a relief to get the accusation out in the open. Let's sit down over here and see if we can't plot a strategy. Bobby, Lisa, come over and sit down. Let's think how your mother would have wanted us to handle this. I'm talking about Renee at her prime, Renee at her best. I miss her. Here I am accused of killing her. And the one person in the world I most want to be here helping me is her.
What
What if the boat's missing? Could Mom have taken it out herself?
I don't think she can handle it herself.
Hi, do you work here?
Yep.
We're looking for our boat, the Beauville.
Yeah, just hang on a sec. Been gone since the 30th. Well, it was here the afternoon of the 29th, but gone morning of the 30th.
You're positive?
Yeah, see, we keep a record. Every day one of us checks the berths to see who's in and who's out.
Were you here late on the 29th?
I usually work late.
Do you punch a time card?
Yeah, I was here.
Okay, so someone had to take the boat out. Do you remember who took it?
A lot of people come in here late. Sometimes they sign the craft out, but sometimes they don't. And, you know, especially if they've had a few.
Well, do you remember anything unusual? You had to see something that was out of the ordinary.
Sorry, nothing that comes to mind.
Can you please just try to think back?
Wait a minute. I do remember seeing a man and a woman. Just before closing up about 2 weeks ago, after that big storm. I'm pretty sure it was that night. I didn't think anything of it because a lot of people get drunk around here, but I noticed them because he was carrying her.
Bobby? Bobby! What are these?
That's just stuff people lost. We keep them there for a while just in case someone wants to claim them.
Bobby! This is hers.
Are you sure?
Yes, she was wearing it that night. It was caught in her. You said that you saw someone carrying a woman?
Yeah, an old guy, maybe 50. Did you notice where they went? It's one of the boats, I guess.
What did he look like?
Kind of tall, thin guy.
If you sank a boat in the middle of the lake, how would you get back to shore if you weren't a great swimmer?
Easy.
Use a dinghy.
Yeah, just use a dinghy.
Have you found any dinghies along the shore that were abandoned?
Maybe one of the other guys did. We store stuff like that out in the back.
Why'd you do it, Dad?
Would do what?
Kill Mom.
Oh, now, Joanna, wait just a minute here. I think we should call a timeout.
It's too late.
It's too late? What do you mean it's too late? Too late for what?
Our boat's gone, Dad. Disappeared. Huh? Someone saw a man carrying a woman into the boat, and the next day it was gone. If I can put it together, the police can, too. If they haven't already.
Joanne, I don't know anything about the boat. I haven't seen that boat in years. The office pays a doctor.
Stop it, all right? Don't make me lose all of my respect for you.
Bobby, will you tell your sister that I was here the night her mother disappeared?
No! No! You don't tell him to lie for you just because he's your son. You tell him the truth. You tell him you're not his father or Lisa's father.
What?
Tell them! Mom had you, but Dad adopted you.
This is so sad.
She was gonna...
Joanne, will you just stop? Just would you stop while you still can? There's just some things in this family we just don't get into.
We are not a family!
Well, if we're not a family, two parents have worked their fingers to the bone for nothing! For nothing!
Who is my father, then?
I am. I am. I raised you. I changed you. I fed you. I am your father.
I don't know, but you better get here fast.
Dad. We know you killed her. So tell us the truth.
Why did you do it, Dad? Why? Why?
My whole life. All I did was clean up after your mother. But I'm not complaining. I was willing to do it. That was my role. Yes. She got into trouble, and I got her out of it. Night at the hotel.
She was driving herself crazy.
After Renee's visit, I had my usual guilt. So I got in my car and drove home through that storm. I sat outside the house. The house there in the rain, just waiting for you kids to leave, so you wouldn't have to listen to that garbage I knew she was going to spew at me.
You on the floor, Clay Chadway. I spit you out.
Just calm down, Renee. Now, let's talk about this like two rational
humans. What do you talk about? You and my sister? How is she, Clay? She better than me? Do you satisfy her?
You've got it all wrong.
Yeah, wrong. Like I have your bookkeeping all wrong. I know what you've been doing with those books.
My books are legal and you know it.
You haven't done anything legal in the last 20 years. Give me a break.
My business is honest. It's always been honest. I've always run an honest business.
Honest? You make me sick. Tell it to the IRS. But better still, tell it to the children. Tell Bobby why you treat him like a dog. And tell Lisa why you have no time for her at all. You just tell him. No, better yet, I'll tell him. I'm going to tell them all. I'm going to tell the whole truth. No more lies. Right here. The whole stinking truth. Tear it up. Tear it up. I'll just write them again. One to Lisa, one to Bobby, and one to the IRS. How do you like that?
That didn't even hurt, Clay. You can't even throw a real punch because you're not a real man. You're a fake husband and you're a fake father!
Oh, damn you, Renee! Damn you! I gave up everything for you. And you and the kids, I gave them everything!
Oh, and what do you think he'll do when they hear about this?
Kill himself.
No, Daddy!
Give me the gun.
No. There's nothing left for me now.
Dad.
I'm not gonna let him put me in jail, son. I can't fight with
you. No, Daddy, stop it! Stop it, Daddy!
No!
Stop it, Daddy!
No!
Hey,
hold it!
You
got her! Release her!
No!
It's all right. It's all right, sweetheart.
Bobby and Lisa will take me home. But I'll see you later, okay?
Count on it.
Hi.
Hi.
Made it on time. Proud of me?
Stunned with disbelief.
Sort of nervous.
Me too. Well, imagine how Dad feels.
Look, Joanne. I mean, you don't have to tell us, but
I've been waiting for you to ask me, both of you. So, who was he? You'd want to know! Okay. Here's what they told me. He worked in a mill with Mom. He was a little bit younger than she was. I don't even know his name or if he's alive now. Is that it? That's it. I'm sorry.
You know, maybe it's not such a good idea to know. I mean, maybe you were right. Who is he at this point anyway?
We should go in.
I'm not gonna go in this time.
I'm not ready either. Tell, Dad. He said hi.
We'll wait here.
They'll be here next time.
Oh, yeah.
They said, give our love to Daddy. Are you okay?
I'm fine. Yes, I'm really fine. Are you going to play tonight? Yeah, one of my compadres said they read that you were going to sing at that club tonight. Ah, well, good. You just knock them dead. You act confident, because you'll be confident if you act confident.
I'll remember.
You tell, tell Lisa that I forgive her for calling the police. In fact, I'm grateful.
She knows.
Joanne, did you tell either of them who their real fathers were?
No, I didn't tell them everything. I sort of lied by omission.
Yeah. A little white lie, you know.
Yeah. Sometimes you just have to tell a little white lie. I don't.